What's up, everybody? Welcome. What is cracking?
Chill.
Yeah.
What's up, everybody?
Damn. Akasa's barbecuing.
Man, better send some shit.
Yeah, Akas. More smoke effects. You got every time someone kills it, you got to do like a smoke, a big smoke effect.
You got to put more.
Yeah.
There you go.
Hell yeah.
More fire.
What's good, everybody? Welcome. BeDrunkKeys.tv homeroom community challenge. Slow tempo scratch challenge. What's good, everybody? We got a bunch of sick videos to watch. And yeah, once again, we're going to crown our slow tempo scratch champ after we get building together. But junkies, are we good to go? Are we ready to start this?
Let's do it.
All right. Where is Ants Drew?
Is Ants there? We're going off the bat like that. Damn.
Is Ants in the house? Shouts out to Ants Drew. I'm not sure. He's in a different time zone, I think. But Ants, you'll see the replay. Let me get the video going. Homeroom crew, make some noise for Ants Drew. Let's go. Make some noise for Ants Drew, y'all. Yeah. All right, y'all. Let's talk to Ants Drew. Go.
Oh, yeah, I guess I kick it off then. Yeah, Ants, that was real dope. I liked it. It's very simple. And very like how you flow on that. I like the little swings to it and stuff. So I always think in terms of more simple stuff sometimes. I mean, not simple, more slow joints. Sometimes it's simple is sometimes way better than just being too intricate. So it was ear pleasing. I think it was dope. And I know it sounds like some type of Griselda beat, but you know, it's really dope. So thumbs up.
I'm just gonna add that was dope, and yeah, that was some type of West Side Gun beat, super slow. I like the scratches. I like how you were doing in two words. You went back. I forgot what the word was, but you went real fast. Well, you did that a couple times. But it was nice, good flow, nice and funky. Yeah, just work on it a little bit more. That's a hard beat to cut to because it's real, real, real slow. But yeah, the more the simpler, the better with something like that. A lot, and then every once in a while, throwing in one of those crazy D-Styles type cuts always makes it even better. But yeah, that's a nice job. Very nice job, man.
Yeah, it's a nice job, man. I like the drags you were doing, especially. You were messing around with the don't stop and all that. You know what I mean? I think it's tough when you're just using phrases and wordplay like that. Like, you really have to structure it out. You know, the way you did it, I liked it a lot, especially using the simple releases and the, you know, just those kind of like run out drags. I think one thing I would like to hear more is if you would have had maybe another sound where you could just kind of solo and go off of, you know, like a longer sound, like a or a fresh. But other than that, man, I thought you did a good job.
Yeah. Everybody, make some noise. Answer Drew, y'all. Come on. Sick. We're off to a good start. Mr. Chalk in the house, y'all.
What up, y'all?
Chocolate.
What's up? Sorry I'm late.
Chocolate.
Home roomies. All right, let's see. Who's up next? Ty V, where you at? Ty V. I'm not sure if Ty V's in the house, y'all, but make some noise. We'll catch us on the replay. Ty V, y'all, let's go.
Ty V, what up?
Hey, y'all, make some noise for Ty V, y'all.
Word up.
That was it. Damn,
Ty V, you was just getting going.
Straight to the point.
Yeah, had to keep it short, man.
Oh, man, that was tight. It was getting interesting right there. That was dope, man. Good job, Ty V, man. Nice shit, man. That was nice. I was wanting more right there.
Thanks.
Yeah, man, real nice flow. Really, I like how you were switching cue points and just pretty much describing what you are, basically, with the scratch and the cut. But really funky cuts in between, like the phrasing and everything, too, man. Really nice, funky, and soulful over the beat. Sounded really good, fresh.
Yeah, I like the swing too when you first started out. I agree with Jay. I was wanting more too and stuff like, but I get it straight to the point, but yeah, I wanted more.
Appreciate it.
Yeah, Ty, that was dope, man. It was a good choice of the beat and, you know, just the phrasing you were doing and you set it up, you know what I mean? To where, you know, we all wanted you to go off after that, you know what I mean? So I thought it was a perfect setup, you know what I mean? But yeah, you did leave us wanting more, man. That was very dope though.
Yeah, Ty. Great stuff, man. I agree with everybody else. And I think the real strong point too was just, you know, being real mindful about dropping the phrase correctly. You know, that goes a long way in my mind as far as being successful using phrases. You know, kind of using it, the rhythm and the cadence of the acapella you're using and putting it to another beat correctly is like an art in itself. You know, so. But yeah, I can't agree with the fellas more, man. I could have used like 30 more seconds for you to just start going in. I felt like you left us at the edge of our seats, man. But good stuff, man. Really good. Everybody, make some noise for Ty V, y'all. Homeroom crew, that's what's up. All right, next up is Kratos in the house. Kratos, where you at? There you go.
Everyone.
What up, Kratos?
Kratos.
Homeroomy, make some noise for Kratos, y'all. Come on.
Kratos, what up, man?
Here we go.
Hi, guys. It's me. I have drugs and sex again. No, I got too much trouble cause I am so fucking stoned. I'm gonna try to make a little mega mix for you. So please, don't piss on me.
It's just the fucking beginning, motherfuckers.
Kratos, y'all, make some noise. Let's go.
Kratos, yeah, man.
Junkies, let's talk to Kratos.
Good job, Kratos, with the phrasing, man. Once again, I like that you knew where everything was at as far as with your visual marker, and then you knew kind of what you were going to do on each word. And you kept it funky throughout the whole, showcase right there. That was dope. And then, you kind of knew also, when to keep it simple and when to kind of incorporate more of your technical scratches, like your two clicks or anything like that. Like you were doing it more on the down. So you kind of double time a little bit and come back to regular flow. It was nice. Good job, Kratos.
Thanks, Joe. Thanks very much.
Rhett, you're muted, Rhett.
Okay. Kratos, I like your overall set. It was real clean and it was also ear pleasing. To add to what Chalk says, you know how to do find the balance. Your phrasing, just the way how you put it together, it was real clean and very ear pleasing. So good job.
Thanks, sir.
I'm just gonna add, I like the phrasing. It was a good overall. I just wanted a few more of the two clips. When you first came out, you did a couple of those and it sounded real dope over that beat. But good job, good phrasing. You were on top of it. You were on top of it. You weren't in the middle of any of the words. Good shit, Kratos. You improving every time, man. But yeah, next time, jump in there, man. Bring couple more of those two clicks in there, man. All that stuff, the technical stuff you were doing, you do it clean. So, it was nice. But good job, man. Good job.
Bye, Jay. Thanks. Next time.
Yeah, Kratos, let me just add, I feel like you understand how to pace yourself more now. Some of the videos that you've done in the past, I feel like you got real busy. And with this, you know how to kind of give yourself some room. And you don't say too much, you know what I mean? And I think with this video right here, you were able to pace yourself, you know what I mean? But I do feel you almost held back a little too much, what Jay was saying when you were doing the those two clicks. At that point, I really wanted you to just kind of go in for the kill, you know what I mean, at that point. But other than that, man, I thought it was dope.
Thanks, also D.
This is Kratos. I agree with everyone's saying, and the only thing I'll add is I can just feel the improvement across the board, man. It was just very well thought out, a lot more, you know, it seemed like you were more at ease with just doing the video, and I can hear the growth, man. Good shit. Homeroomies, make some noise for Kratos.
Kratos, what up?
Awesome, y'all. All right, moving along. Is Mac Yeezy in the house? Mac Yeezy. Mac's in another time zone. He might be at work or some shit, but all right, everybody, he'll catch us on the replay. Hey, everyone, are you guys seeing like all my windows whenever I show the videos? Is that what's happening? Like, can you guys see the videos when I'm sharing?
It's like a block is happening or something. Like we can see you moving it too. Like,
yeah, move whatever that is, move that over, Babs.
Yeah, so like it blocks the screen a little bit.
Okay, so I'm sharing now. Am I blocking?
Whatever that square bit, for your mouse.
Yeah. Yeah, you need to move that.
Move it to the right, or yeah.
Yeah, to the right.
Hold on.
Yeah, Mac Easy's here.
Mac's here?
Yeah.
He's here.
Everyone, homeroomies, make some noise for Mac Easy.
Mac Easy.
How's that, y'all?
That's good.
Yes.
Much all right. Better. Sorry about that, guys. Here we go. Mac Easy. Junkies.
Talk to him.
Mac, it was really dope, man. I'll be the first one to say that, like, real slow tempo beats for me that's my kryptonite. I'm not really good at it, and I can tell. Maybe I don't know. I might be wrong, but that particular phrase, that Busta Rhyme phrase, is, I know that's a real tricky thing. And so, but once you get into it, and also until you get to your solos, that's when it's like, you really get busy and stuff like that. So, I mean, so I know a lot of people are like, they like more slow tempo. I'm more mid range, but I have to say the way, when you got real busy, towards the end, I wanted more, but, yeah, slow tempos are hard, and you did a great job.
Mac Yeezy, I liked your flow, man. It's funny because, like, you know, with slow tempo beats, you could do a real time or you could do double time. And, you know, when you start off, which is kind of like doing the taps in between the phrase and in between the words, I expected, like, I don't know if I expected you to go like double time right away, but you didn't. Like, you kind of just like built your own flow with it. And like, you kept building it towards the end. Like, that's when you start incorporating a little bit more of like the tasers and, you know, a couple of little double time scratches here and there. But yeah, I like the way that you flowed with it at all throughout the whole thing, because again, I was expecting more of a double time, you know, the way you were kind of building up, but you kept like staying in like in real time with the beat. And that was dope, dude. I liked your overall flow with the whole thing. Good job.
Mac, yeah, good stuff, Mac. You had some nice nice combinations in there, throwing in all kinds of scratches. One thing I just want to add, though, is when you're messing around with the sample like that, just make sure that the sample is on beat. You know, pitch it up, just because I feel like the sample might have been too fast, and so when you release it, you know what I mean. It was playing ahead of the beat at times, and it makes it more difficult to flow, especially when you're doing like 16th note type scratches and stuff. So yeah, just make sure that the sample is pitched up correctly.
I'm just gonna add a good flow. Yeah, same thing everybody's saying. Just get the buster, get the phrase, the wording on beat. Because if you would have slowed it down, think you had a little bit too fast. And even if you have it slowed down where you can make the beat yourself. So it would be, you're going, as I come back. But if you even slowed it down, you can, as I come back, flip the set. You can get more control with the wording. But other than that, I like the pullbacks. I like the flow. It was nice. And I like how it built up into the technical stuff later at the of the routine. At first, it was nice. It was a good flow. And then you're like, you know what? I'm going to pull out my other cuts from my bag. And you did that. And it was good. Good job, man. Good job, Mac. Easy.
Yeah, man. Good job. I can't agree with the guys enough about it. I think the biggest thing was just getting your sample on time. You know, you have great technique, you got a great arsenal, but you know, when you're dealing with a phrase, really tight words, you know, you're really dependent on how that phrase sounds when you release it, you know, and a lot of the patterns I think you wanted to achieve are so dependent on it hitting the beat right. So, you know, you got to spend a little time and make sure, oh, Mac's in here now. You got to take that time to make sure it's hitting the beat right. And, you know, and you see a lot of people too, you know, you might play it at double time, you know, and with an ultra pitch, you might have, like Jay was saying, you might have gone and slowed it super down and made it be in pocket too. So, but other than that, good job. Appreciate you, everybody. Homeroomies, make some noise for Mac Easy.
Mac Easy.
What's up, Mac? I don't know if you saw that, but catch a replay.
Yeah.
Good stuff, y'all. All right. Next up, where is Juice One? Aw, shit.
Juice One, where you at?
Orale.
What up, hey, fellas.
What's up, Juice?
What's up?
Juice One in the house, y'all. Here we go.
The truth is that
elite actors can get ripped while adding 12, 15, even 20.
What the heck?
Juice One every time, man. Every time. Just crazy improvement, man. Again, I know you've only been DJing for a short amount of time, man, but your comprehension of everything has just gets better every video, dude. Every community challenge we do, you rise to the occasion every time, man. And just keep working hard, brother. Like it's coming out by itself. You know what I'm saying? You got it. You definitely got it. You understand it. You just keep putting in the time that you're putting in. And yeah, that was super funky, man. And I just like the fact that you like looked at the camera, let them know that, you know, people about to catch it right now. So y'all feel what I'm doing. So yeah, Juice, that was dope, dude. Keep going, man, because you're getting better and better every time, brother. Salute.
Yeah, man.
Thank you, Chuck.
Juice, I feel like every time you look at the camera, you're about to shank us and stuff. So, I mean, the patterns, you know, it's repetitive, but it's clean the way it, because you make sure you made sure that each of it is heard very time. Sometimes it's, you know, to doing a repetitive patterns, you have to do that a couple times to have people to catch up to understand the patterns. And I could be wrong, man, but I think it's almost like you're doing the seesaw scratch kind of. Does it sound like he was doing the seesaw scratch? But
I was just trying to do the chirps.
Oh, it was the chirps. Okay. Yeah. All right. Well, either way, it sounds great. It's, you know, like Chalk says, like, you know, you, like you said, you told us you started in February and it's already September. So, man, keep up the great work, man, for real.
It's amazing, brother.
I want to add my two cents is great effing job. And also, I like the flow. I like how you, it's kind of like a rap song. Like you were, dip-a-tip-a-ta, hey, yep, dip-a-dip. And then you had that one part. Like that was dope. And then you switched it. You did that pattern for a couple of times. And then when you switched it up, you did a little bit of more, a different rap. And it was a good flow, man. It was definitely up there. You're not sounding boo-boo. Just keep at it, man. Just get that scratch. Just get your game up and you got keep improvement. And it shows every time you get on here. But yeah, good job, man. Definitely good job. Good flow. Like I said, it sounded like a rap. You were doing it nice to the beat. And you shine, you let that little glimmer come through, then you went right back to that flow. And it was dope, man. Good job, Juice, man. Real good job.
Thank you.
Juice, it's crazy because you really know how to compliment the beat. You know what I mean? As simple as it needed to be. You were at the same time like very lyrical with it, you know what I mean? And towards like every fourth bar, you were throwing in like a one click flair, I think, right? Was that what that was?
Yeah.
Damn, that's crazy, man. Yeah,
trying.
February.
crazy. Yeah, great stuff, man. Super dope.
Thank you.
Awesome, Juice. I can't agree with the guys enough. So sick. What beat was that?
That's Locksmith's new song that he just dropped, Survival.
Yeah. That was hype. I felt it. I felt like you were like just really locking in with the beat and great example of like just owning what's in your arsenal, man. And yeah, can't agree enough with the guys, man. Awesome improvement as well, man. Keep at it, man. Good stuff. Home Roomies, Juice One, make some noise.
One, yeah, man. You love to see it. You love to see it. So,
you see it.
You see it.
All right. Copious One. Did I see Copious earlier?
Snap. Copious, what up?
What up, y'all? How's it going?
What's up, brother?
Good.
Homeroom crew, make some noise for Copious One.
Copious. Let's go.
Do it.
Ladies and gentlemen,
introducing
we need to talk about your flair. This is home.
Make some noise, Copious One, y'all.
Copious One, word up. Dope.
Copious. I man, overall, this is dope. It's really dope. It's clean. And it always is crazy how you do it on a portable. So, man, keep, you know, I don't, nothing really to say except it's just really dope, man. So,
thank you, Rhett. I appreciate that, man.
Yeah. I'm going to add, that was nice. Good flow. Continuous. You switched it up a lot. I definitely would love the chirps when they came in and did all, you did all that. It was funky. It was real nice. The beat, you complimented the beat. You didn't overshine it, and you picked the nice sound that went with the beat. You didn't have like some, oh, it was, you just had like a nice something real funky that went with the beat, and that was dope, man. It was super dope, Copious, man. Good job.
I threw in that fade for you, man.
I already heard it, man. I didn't want to call it out, man, but I heard it. I know the voice. Yeah, that was dope, man. And did you make that beat, or was that something?
Nah, that's a Wonder Cup beat.
Okay, yep, Wonder Cup. Yes, sir. Rest in peace, man, brother, man. Nah, that's good. Represent the brother. That's right. That's how you do it too, man. That's how you do it. 100%.
Thank you, Jay.
It's really, really dope, man. Yeah, I definitely loved the Wonder Cut tribute in the front that you had with the beginning of the video, well, throughout the whole video. But I'd like the build up to everything that you were doing as far as like the double time chirps and stuff like that. But then when you what did it say? Let's talk about your flair. And then you went and you kept that rocking for a second, man. And that was really, really dope, man. It was like you were just letting us know what you were gonna do throughout the routine. And I liked that a lot, man. It was well constructed, well thought out, and super dope, man. Funky.
Thank you, Chuck. I did the scribble transform.
Yeah, I saw that. The one forward, two back with the scribble. Yeah. Yeah, that was dope, man. Super dope. Salute.
Thank you.
Yeah, Copious, man. Great job. I think overall, man, you just have a lot of flavor, like, in your cuts. You know what I mean? And, you know, like, it really shined on this one. I really liked how you were pacing yourself and, like, you would use silence at certain parts, you know what I mean, towards like the end of like certain bars. I loved how you were incorporating some of the pushes towards the end and the forward drags, you know what I mean? And I think by doing that, it really gives your cuts like a voice, you know what I mean? And it really stands out, you know what I mean? And I loved how you ended it with the volume fade going down too. That was like a very dramatical way to end it. It was dope. Great job.
Thank you, D. I appreciate that, man.
Awesome job, Copious. I loved it. Just great execution, man. Great presentation. Nice and clean, man. I don't think I heard you have a hiccup throughout the whole thing. Flow sounding tight. That OG flair is super locked in, man. But good stuff, brother. Good stuff.
Thank you, Babs. I appreciate it.
Yeah. Homeroom crew. Make some noise. Copious One.
Yeah, man.
Oh. Awesome, everybody. All right, moving along. Where is Series One?
Where you at?
Yeah, hey, what's up, everybody?
Series One in the house.
What up, what up?
How are you?
What up?
That's what's up, man. Everybody, make some noise. Series One.
Yeah.
You're wet. and it's all for you. You're a fuck, fuck, fuck.
That was dope. I mean, overall, just like I used you, how you used the casual line, and then just the whole, your whole set is clean. It's just like you had, it's like a song, pretty much a song and stuff. So enough technical stuff, but I still keep it simple, but ear pleasing. I mean, the using the effects as well. Just, man, it was dope. So, and if you don't mind me asking, Sirius, what beat is that? Did you make that, or is that a?
No, that's that was Dell's Phony Franchise, the Domino remix.
Oh wow! Okay.
Yeah. Wow. So.
That's dope. Keep it high, roll. That's dope.
Yeah, I slowed it down though.
Oh okay. No, yeah, it was
faster than that.
Okay. Yeah, that was really dope, man. So good job.
No, thanks, Rhett.
Yeah, you slowed that beat way down, right? That beat was faster than that. Yeah, okay.
Yeah.
That was nice, man. Good use of the echo, good pacing. You didn't jump right in it. And like Brett was saying, it was more of a song structure that you did. And like that it's all your, all that was like the chorus. And then when you came back in, it was dope. And then I'm going to say, I liked how you didn't have a bunch of cue points and you just rewound. Like you didn't rely on all that stuff. You just knew exactly, I have one cue point. This is where my thing starts. I know all my markers. I know where each line is on that dot. But that was good. Good job, Sirius One. Yeah, good flow, good pacing, good use of all the echo and all that, man. Dope, man. Very nice. Very clean.
Thanks, Jay.
Nah,
appreciate it.
And on point with the words too. You didn't come in your fault. You didn't come in with any like that. You came in each time and we understood what it was exactly. Everybody was getting offended in the chat. So they knew exactly what was being said.
Yeah, we now know whose fault it is for sure.
That is. Stray bullets.
Pow, pow, pow. good funky flow, man. Really, the only thing I need to add to what everybody else has said already is just with the echo, when you're doing scratch flow like that, use it more as a trigger, more so than flipping the switch up, because that's just more time for you to now to flip the switch back on. So just use the trigger,
okay, gotcha.
Down, and then like, you know, you'll have the same effect, but now you're doing half the work, is what I'm trying to say. So you don't have to reach back up again and turn it back off.
All right.
Yep. But other than that, folks, dope stuff, Sirius.
Thank you.
Yo, what's up, Sirius? Yeah, man, I love the wordplay, like how you set everything up. And that complemented the beat very well. I liked how you kind of structured it out to like chorus, solo, chorus. And it was like well composed, like the way that you spaced everything out, you know what I mean? And the way you use the echoes and everything. Like I love the minimalism of it, you know what I mean? The less is more type of thing. And then just the way you ended it on an acapella note and then scratched the beat back in too was real, real dope and dramatic. I gotta ask, do you make beats or do you work with like MCs?
No, I don't.
Okay.
I want to get into that, but gotcha. Yeah.
Yeah, you have
learning from you, D.
No, because you kind of have that like composer style, you know what I mean? Where you're given space and like you understand how to set it up for like an MC to go off like right after, you know? So yeah.
Yeah, this is something I normally don't it's normally not my style. You know, usually I just cut it up, but you know, with this, I want to have fun with it, try something different for me anyway. So,
gotcha, man. Yeah, great job, man.
Thanks, yeah,
I'm gonna add, D, but just what D said, those are perfect chorus cuts, or so, like someone was about to come in after the echo faded out. It was good job, man. Yeah, I just wanted to add that. Go ahead, Mr. Chalk.
No, I just did. I did already.
Mellow D, go ahead, Mellow.
Mellow's not here.
Oh, damn it.
I want to say, you know, I think D said it best, less is more. Less is more. And, you know, I thought it showed a lot of, it was real good taste, the way you work with the beat, the phrasing, everything. Good job, brother. Killed it. Thanks, Homeroom man. Crew. Makes a noise. Series one, y'all. Let's go. Awesome, everybody. All right, we're moving along. And next up, where is, hold on before I Steve Harvey us here. Laurent, is Laurent in the house?
Laurent's
never with us because I think he's in France, but he'll watch us on the replay. Everybody, make some noise for Laurent, everybody. Here we go.
Steve Harvey.
Got a lot of private information on that window today.
Man.
did we lose that one?
We lost that one. That one was lost.
Yeah.
The audio was still good. Buddy Lee, you're right. Buddy Lee.
Sorry, guys. Should I run it back from the top?
Yeah, run it back, man.
My bad, y'all. Hold on.
Wait. Man.
Sorry, guys.
All right.
My bad.
No, you good.
By the tempo. Make some noise for Laurent, y'all.
Laurent, good job, man. Funky. I like the choice of the music. Is it because I'm black? Very good. Very good choice of the song. Now that was fly though. The horns. I liked how you was taking a chance, and you did that with the horn and made a song out of it more or less with that loop. The go ahead scratch, that was dope. My only thing would be is just to practice like stopping words. Don't be afraid to record control. So go ahead, like kind of to the rhythm of it would be the only thing I would say, but it was nice. Nice flow, everything else was nice. I like how you brought that back with the horn. And I like the on beat, the wording, at a tempo, the at a tempo scratch, whatever you would say, I forgot already, but that was sick. And you had that perfectly on beat, and even you were able to find a different part of the sentence and bring it back without using a bunch of cue points. You had cue points, but you still brought it back with the flow of the scratch. Good job, Laurent. Good job.
Yeah, Laurent, super dope, man. Truly played the turntable like an instrument. Knew where everything was at as far as like looking at your visual marker, not relying on technology at all. Super dope. The only thing I want to tell you, because I think that you understand all the moves and all the scratches that you're doing to even get those even sharper and have better releases and transformers and all that, watch your crossfader distance. I was watching your crossfader when you were scratching and you were using the full distance. If you're only using a quarter of the distance or a half of the distance, you'll have a lot more sharper transformers, releases. You have more control over your releases, all of that, just watching your crossfader distance. But other than that, I mean, again, you get all the moves, you understand what you're doing. I'm just telling you stuff, something's gonna help you improve even more. But super dope and funky job, man. Keep it up, keep up the good work.
B-Rad would be impressed.
to add to what Jay and Chalk says, I mean, the overall concept was dope, you know. I guess also another thing too to add is like maybe kind of like also the levels of your scratch sounds and stuff, because it sounds a little bit louder than the track itself, if you can like find the right balance of it. Other than that, yeah, I mean, I have to agree with Chalk. If you can get that a little bit more tighter and stuff, but the concept itself is great. Like I said, my kryptonite is slow beats, but you know, but what you did over there is really dope. So good job, Laurent. So
Laurent, awesome stuff. Great job. I feel like you know, what you were trying to execute was you know, you were just awesome, like advanced concepts, you know. So I think like, you know, you've set a pretty high bar for yourself dealing with like one part you were doing musical instruments and another part you were doing phrases and, you know, and you're keeping it pretty real, just using your visual markers and having a lot of big spin backs and keeping everything on time. I mean, that alone was tough enough. But yeah, I love the concept. And I think as your skills fill in more, you know, doing something like this, it's like you already have the idea. Now it's just a matter of like, you just tightening up your techniques a little bit more, and when it all comes together, you're going to be destroying, man. So,
yeah,
good stuff. Everybody, make some noise, Laurent, y'all.
Laurent, word up,
killer, everybody. Sorry for the technical difficulties, guys. My bad. Like I always say, technical difficulties are always better than testicular difficulties, right? All right.
I don't want to know about the other one. from any of y'all.
Next up, it's in the book. Where you at?
It's in the book.
What's cracking, people? What's cracking?
Home roomies, make some noise. It's in the book, in the house.
Yeah.
Let's go.
Thank you.
Look.
Yes, sir.
What, so you chose to do this on a controller this time. You got turntable still, right?
No, I don't. I had to give back the turntable to my homeboy.
So
I am back on the controller. No worries.
I mean, hey, man, you know, life happens. Whatever happens, you keep it moving, man. And I'm just always impressed with anybody who can scratch on those controllers, man, because I've tried it myself and it's just a headache for me. But to see somebody else do it and to see them have a flow with it and get their cuts off too is pretty amazing to me, man. Because, you know, I'm used to having something that's moving, and, you know, those type of controls that you were using, the platters don't move on those. So you just have a visual marker that you're kind of looking at, you know, like a little lighted dot or whatever on the platter itself to like.
I don't even have that. Like,
oh, you don't have that?
Yeah, like I'll put the screen on library mode and I'll just do that.
Oh, snap. Well, and yeah. You still made it happen. Hey, man. Well, good stuff, man. I heard the one clicks in there. You know, I think you got a good flow, man. And I think once you do get back to like turntables or even a better controller, I think your flow is even going to be even more dangerous, man. But keep up the good work. Keep working. Whatever life throws at you, man, keep just like deflecting it and keep it moving forward, man. All right.
Yeah, appreciate it. Yeah, man. To go from the Dex to the controller, I was low-key depressed.
Oh man, but the cuz didn't tell it at all, man. You still got yeah. So just keep working, keep rocking.
Yeah, appreciate it.
Word up.
Man, what's your homeboy's problem, man? What's his problem? What's his problem? No, but good job, brother. I love the presentation. Good to see you still at it. And, you know, I remember you mentioned in class before that you had to go back to the controller, but it's all good. It's all good, man. You still touching sound. That's all that matters, man. Mm-hmm. One thing I will say, I know the controller you're talking about, and you know, if you don't have a visual marker on your platter, I see you putting your eye on the laptop a lot. Obviously, that's you know, your next way of you know, being able to track where you're at. But you know, watch out for that habit, because you're gonna get back on them turntables one day, and you're gonna want to be, you know, looking at the audience or looking at your visual markers. And not looking like we're doing our taxes in front of the crowd, right? You know, so, you know, it's a hard, I've just seen students before where they get so locked in dependent on that screen. When you get away, it's like driving blind all of a sudden, you know, like, so just be careful of that habit. And you know what I'm saying? Like, you know, one thing you can do to keep yourself honest is just hitting a space bar when you're in Serato and the waves go away. You know, that's something we always do at school. But other than that, man, one click flare sounding solid, man. I thought it was really cool how you were using effects to and a repetitive pattern to kind of like give us a little more composition and give it a little tension and release. But great stuff, Book. Good to see you.
Appreciate it. Thank you.
Yeah.
Books, I you know, only thing I can add is that I love the overall flow of it. And yeah, props to you on using the controller, because I'm unlike Chalk, man. I suck in controllers and stuff like that. And so the way that you did it was great. I agree with Babs too. Just don't look. If you could somehow, you might have to get used to, like, since the platters don't move, just like, you know, just got to get used to a feel for it, and still try to not look at the laptop. Cause I seen cats who can fuck it up on controllers the controller. Like a perfect example is Dynamics, you know? So yeah. You just have to kind of figure out the movement and the feeling and stuff, but you can, you know, but it's there. What instrumental were you using, if you don't mind asking?
Oh, that was, It's a Vibe.
It's a Vibe by
It's a Vibe.
Yeah, 2 Chainz.
Oh, yeah. It's 2 Chainz. Okay. Yeah. Okay. That's what's up, man. So yeah, good shit.
Appreciate it.
Homeroomies, make some noise. It's in the book, y'all. All right, y'all, moving along. Where is Jimmy G in the house? Anyone seen Jimmy G? I think Jimmy's one of our students from overseas. He'll watch us on the replay, y'all. But homeroom crew, make some noise for Jimmy. Here we go. Make some noise for Jimmy, y'all.
Hey, yeah.
All right, junkies, let's talk to Jimmy.
Set it off, somebody.
All right, well, I'll set it off. Jimmy, nice flow, very dope. The scratches were all complimented the beat. That's the most important thing for me. The only thing I will say is you... Don't look at the waveforms, as we were telling. It's in the book. Once you get used to that waveform, and because it's on the mixer, it's even easier to look at now. But I think if you just don't look at that and just scratch, your scratches will become more of a flow, and you're not so nervous about what sound I'm on and. Where I'm at with the thing. It was nice though, good flow. The beat was dope. And I like to say what? That was dope. Very good job, man. Good job, Jimmy. Jimmy G.
Jimmy. Yeah, good stuff, man. I could tell like you have a lot of scratches in your arsenal, and I enjoyed your overall flow, but I feel like your flow is even gonna get even better the more you practice. I could tell just like you're able to execute certain scratches and certain combos with ease. But I think like once you like really get your flow even tighter, it's just gonna be, all your scratches are gonna connect better. You know what I'm saying? So I think that you did an awesome job. But yeah, I can see there's a lot of moves in your arsenal and I wanna see your flow even get even better than what it is now. Your flow's good, but I wanna see it get even better. But overall, great job with what you're doing, Jimmy. Keep going and keep practicing a lot.
I'm just going to add to that, Jimmy. Don't look at the waveform and what Mr. Chalk is talking about, it'll start coming to you.
Mm-hmm.
Let that flow. Don't look at the wave. Anybody that looks at the waveform, you're too busy looking at this. You're like, oh, am I on it? Nah, you got to just trust your scratches.
Yeah.
Trust yourself and trust your scratches. And it's going to even get better. But yeah, go ahead. Next, Redmatic, what you got, man?
The same as what the guy said. Yeah, I mean, nothing to add. I do. What stood out to me was like your double time stabs and flares and stuff like that. So, you know, it complemented it. So, real good job.
Yeah, Jimmy, I can tell you're real comfortable doing stabs, and you know, when you were doing those double time stabs, I liked it because it created this sort of this like melodic chorus that you were doing. I heard you throwing some two click flares, some one click flares, and I think what you could work on is integrating them together now. So rather than doing two or four bars of a two click flare, and then two or four bars of a one click flare, maybe trying to see how you can incorporate them in doing combinations with one another. You know what I mean? You had some nice echoes. I like the way that you were using the echoes and everything. But yeah, good job overall, man.
Homeroom crew, make some noise for Jimmy G. All right, y'all. Moving along. Grubbernaut, where you at? I know I saw Grubbernaut earlier.
Where you at, Grubbernaut? I saw you earlier, too.
Scott, you here?
Where you at? There he is.
There he is.
What up, Grubbernaut?
Home roomies, make some noise for Grubbernaut. Let's go.
Grubbernaut.
Y'all
show some love. Set it off, somebody.
Kick it off, Chalk.
Oh. Just the law passed to me, huh? Okay, word, Rhett. Funky sound, Grubbernaut. Good job, man. I love the overall. I mean, I love phrasing, period, man. So anytime I hear somebody phrasing, I always want to see what they're gonna do with the phrase. And I loved your approach to it and your overall flow with it. Something that was mentioned on somebody else's video, I can't remember who else's video we were talking about, but I think like if you would have pitched it down, the sample down a little bit more, it would have been like right in the pocket of that beat. But I enjoyed what you were doing in between the words also to your cuts. And like there was one, I think you were doing like a hyper chirp and then like into like a release, but you kept your hand on the record and then you would pull it back. It was a nice little combo you had in there. You had a couple of combos in there that were really, really dope and funky, man. But yeah, just my overall thing is just, I think if you would have pitched it down a little bit more, it would have been right in the pocket. But overall, what you were doing with the phrase was funky and the cuts are in the arsenal, man. I hear you staying sharp as always, Grubbernaut. So salute to you and good job as always, brother.
Yeah, so same thing. That was the only thing I guess, critique is that to get the timing down with the phrase. But your combos, man, it was really dope. Just hearing your different combinations and stuff. So that's the only thing I would also have to agree with Chuck. Just the timing on the phrase sentences, just to get that. It's very important. That kind of, I think it, if you get that, sets off everything. So, but other than that, great job, Cribbernaut.
I'm gonna add, yeah, I like the cuts. I like the whole arsenal, and you definitely got it popping. And just like the other fellas are saying, though, yeah, everybody in this chat, getting those words on beat is super important. And even if you don't get them on beat, make them on beat yourself. Don't be afraid to touch that record. This is probably the fifth time I said it, but don't be afraid to touch that record and stop it in between each word and not letting it go. I know I forgot who it was, but there's, I don't know if I forgot. Yeah, somebody back in, I don't know if it was Raider, D or Mike or somebody, but they used to scratch with the phrase a little faster so they could have more control. It was something weird like that, but I think it's just, you just got to learn that record control and learn how to pause it in between each word, and you'd be fine, because there's nothing wrong with the cuts. You're getting busy, and definitely good improvement going down with the cuts. But yeah, just that phrasing, that's probably the only thing. But yeah, it was good job regardless of all that.
Yeah, Scott. Yeah, I know where you're at with it, Scott, and it's like, it's a tough world. You know, that world that you're trying to scratch in, it's a few rabbit holes that happen when you start talking about phrasing at this tempo that you're doing, you know? And I think, like, I can't, you know, emphasize what all the guys are saying enough is making sure that when you release that phrase, that it's in pocket. Now, with this slow tempo challenge, and now that a lot of us have ultra pitches, you know, you could have took that phrase and matched it to the beat in a couple different ways, right? You know, it could have been like more of the double time side, or it could be more like a halftime thing where you're pitching down to like negative 50. So, you know, either way, I think the real thing about phrasing is, you know, really understanding the mathematics of the phrase and just how it sounds, just dropping on the beat. And from there, I think, like, if you revisit that phrase with the same exact approach, I think you're going to get a lot different results if you've got that phrase in pocket. So, and a lot of times it's tough. You hear a phrase, and if you don't know the song or you don't know the context that whoever that rap lyric is coming from, you might not hear it in the way that it's supposed to be on the beat. And I don't say you have to put it like that, but I think it helps tremendously. And every time I go to scratch a phrase off a record, because a lot of times too, like back in the day, if you didn't have an acapella, and you had to scratch something that had a beat in the background too, I would follow that more than I'd follow the rap lyric. I used to always pay so much attention. If Havoc from Mobb Deep said, "Worst come to worst, my peoples comes first on a two and," then when I go to drop it on this Alchemist beat, I'm dropping it on a two and also, you know, because, you know, I thought it made such a big difference that phrase is going to be in pocket as well. So, yeah, man, I think just spending a little bit more time and understanding the phrase is going to go a long way with you, Scott, because, you know, you're doing a lot of advanced concepts already, but I think it's all going to come together once you just make sure that phrase is in pockets to begin with. So, but good stuff, brother, always.
Yeah.
Yo, can I just add that, Scott, like, I felt like you really locked it in and dialed it in towards the middle, though. Like, in the beginning when you were dropping the phrase, it was a little loose, and I wasn't sure where you were going with it, but then towards like the middle part, towards the ending, that's when I felt like you kind of found the pocket for it and really kind of locked it in. Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Scott, good job. Everybody, make some noise for Grubbernaut.
I think he was trying to say something, but his mic, I think you were muted, Grubbernaut.
Scott, speak up. Sorry, man.
Yeah, we can't hear you, brother. We see your mouth moving, but we can't hear you.
Scott, we can't hear you though. Are you unmuted?
Hold on. Can you hear me now?
There you go. Yeah. What's up, Grubbernaut?
That's my headphones. I was just going to say that thank you very much. That's dope feedback, because I was struggling with it, but I couldn't figure out where And so that's dope to hear that and figure out that's what was going on.
Yeah.
No, sure. Appreciate it.
At a certain point, Scott, you might ask somebody and they might hear the phrase totally different. So, you know, fuck my opinion at the end of the day. But I think at the end of the day, you know, mathematically, there is some kind of relation that or pocket that, you know, you should be trying to find out. You know what I'm saying? But I love the phrase. I love the beat. I love your cuts. I say revisit that, you know, through a different lens and maybe just find the exact pitch where it's at. And yeah, I think that would make a huge difference next time around for sure.
Yeah. Dope.
Homeroomies, Grub or Not?
Grub or Not.
All right. Next up, Seasick, where you at?
Oh, snap.
Hey, wait. What beat was that? Grub or Not? The beat. Sound like Mr. Oizoi something. What was that beat? Tight.
Oh, he's muted again.
I'd have to look it up, to be honest. I can't recall offhand.
Okay.
If you want to tell us, Scott, it's all good. But hey, you know.
Yeah, go ahead and keep it a secret, bro. Bernard, it's all good. We see you, man.
I'll look it up and throw it in the chat.
We're a community, bro. You know, we were a community, you know. All good. Just kidding, Scott.
Hey, that sounded like Hudson Mohawk. I don't know.
You're saying it sounds like Hudson Mohawk?
Yeah, because I think I have that beat.
Oh, of course you do. Of course you do.
Thanks, Grub or Not. Seasick, sorry, where you at? Oh, there he is.
Seasick, what up,
everyone?
Got the LA hat on. We see you, son. We see you.
Home room, make some noise for Seasick. Here we go.
Seasick, yeah.
Son, you know why you the greatest alive? Why, Dad? Because you came out of my balls, nigga.
Y'all make some noise, homeroomies.
Yeah.
Dick.
What up?
Woo. Very good, man. Good good all around scratches. You got a bunch of the concepts popping. But before everybody gets into it, I'm gonna say congratulations on getting the phrasing popping. You got the phrasing nice. You were on beat with all of it. Your record control game was off the Richter scale. It was off the rack. That was very good control and good making sure everything was on beat. The yeah, all that stuff. It all was on. It was all head nodding on beat. Good shit, man. Good job, C-Sit.
Thank you.
Rhythmatic.
Yeah.
Lopez.
Whoop. Man, yeah, great job on that. Seasick. Overall, I have nothing bad to say. It's just it was very clean. It was very ear pleasing. You had different combos. That was great. So, what beat was that? If you don't mind me asking,
that's Homicide by Logic.
Okay. Okay. But yeah, that shit is real dope, dude. So very clean. Keep up the great work.
Thanks.
Yes, he's sick. Super dope, man. Good flow in the pocket. I see you. You like the one click, and also were you doing like a release chirp one click? Is that what you were doing? I'm not sure. It sounded like it was, but I mean, overall, whatever you were doing, it sounded really, really good together. And you kind of know what combos you have in your arsenal and which ones to kind of like go in and out of, you know. So I like the way you were phrasing also too, with I Can Break It Down. That was dope. And yeah, just overall, just dope flow. I think every time I see a video from you, man, you get funky and funky with your flow, man. So salute to you, C-Sick. Keep it up, brother.
Thank you.
Yes, sir.
Yo, C-Sick, man, that was a great job. I love the intro and the beat that you chose. And one thing that really stood out to me was when you were cutting Fresh, you were messing with the first half with the fret and then the shh. And I think most people are scared to even touch that shh part, man, but you were freaking it, you know what I mean? And that's a hard sound, I feel like, to mess with, because it's such a high frequency, you know what I mean? But I loved how you were messing with that and you broke it into like two parts right there. Everything was clean and funky, man. Great job.
Thank you.
There he is.
Ooh, Babu.
Babu.
What you got for us, Babs?
Oh, okay. Am I unmuted now?
Yeah, there you go.
All right, sorry about that. Good job, C-Sick. I loved it too. I thought it was I thought, you know, you showed a dope variety, and I just loved how you're moving through the sounds, and your flow sounded nice and comfy, man. Yeah, great stuff again, man. Hear the improvement. Keep it up. Good stuff, brother.
Thank you.
Homerooms. Yeah. Nice to see C-Sick, y'all.
C-Sick, word up.
All right, y'all. Moving right along. Oh, snap. Miguel.
Uh-oh.
He's been waiting.
Miguel. Yeah, there he is. What up, Miguel?
Yeah, Miguel was here.
Hey, what's up, guys?
We see you, brother. What's up?
What's up, Miguel? Homeroomies. Make some noise for your boy, Miguel. Here we go.
Miguel.
Nice.
Yeah. Make some noise for Miguel, y'all.
Miguel. New style. Set it off.
What's up, Miguel? Hey. Man, that was, that was overall, like, super clean. I love your approach to it, man. You're always, doing these live, like, compositions. You really have your phrasing locked, like super clean, locked, you know what I mean? Like, I don't think there was any like errors or anything in that, you know what I mean? The only thing I can say is that, and I think this is a good thing, is you set it up and you left us like, or you left me at least like wanting to hear more, you know what I mean? So I think that's a good thing. Was that shorter than normal? Was that like 90 seconds?
It was like just over a minute, I think.
Okay. I mean, not mad if you did another 30 seconds or whatever next time, but yeah. Yeah, super dope.
Kind of ran out of time on this one.
Yeah, solid work as always, Miguel. I mean, again, what I love about your videos, you always make it your own, man. And I can always tell, like, you put in time in the production part of it all, and also thinking about what you're going to do on the cuts. So I can tell it's like an all-day thing for you when you set in for these challenges. But overall flow was good. Like to just to like agree with D Styles also too with the phrasing. Your phrasing is really locked in and on point. You kind of know where everything is at, what you're gonna do on each word, everything too with the cuts in your arsenal. So yeah, man. Good flow as always. Good job with making the routine your own as far as like with your, the way you produce it, and solid work as always, Miguel. Salute.
Awesome. Thank you.
Yeah.
Yeah, Miguel. Always creative. Oh, every challenge is always creative. You always push it. So nothing to really add except that, like I said, it's just creative. Keep up the great work.
Was that your own beat right there, Miguel?
No, that's a Linkin Park.
Oh, that was a Linkin Park song?
Yeah.
Okay, well, I even like it even more, man. You took the chance. You was like, I'm going to scratch over some Linkin Park.
Put a nail in the coffin.
Just what the fellas were saying, man. I definitely appreciate the phrasing. And I like how you made sure it was on beat. And you used your record control as far as I can break it down. Like, you made sure everything was on beat with it, and it was real dope, man. Real good job. Good, interesting choice of a beat, and it fit. It was a nice fit. Good shit, man. Definitely good shit.
Cool, thank you.
Yeah, I can't. I can't see nothing wrong with it. Just like B was saying, that was good.
Miguel, good work. Awesome as usual. I thought your phrasing was great. You know, way to work with the music and build up all that energy and everything. I was waiting for you just to go buck wild on the sound, though. I think that was the last thing I was waiting for. You know what I mean? Like, you just, it was such a good build up, and I felt like, okay, it would have felt right for you to just to go ham on an ah refresh or, you know, oh yeah, or something at the end and just showed your arsenal. You know what I'm saying? But, you know, other than that, man, always.
I did chop off the end because I it wasn't coming out. I had to spend a lot of time on the beginning part, and I ran out of time to make it fresh. So yeah, I did chop off the next, last bit.
Next time. Nah, yeah. Good work though. Good work though, Miguel. Everybody, yes. Homeroom crew, make some noise for Miguel, y'all. Yeah. Good stuff, brother. All right, we're moving along. All right. The word's out in the chat, guys. We're on Twitch.
Words on the street, man. I'm watching also on Twitch, man. Give me some numbers.
Well, word is out. Subscribe to us. Follow us. All right. Wish one, where you at? Wish.
Elbows. Here. Elbows.
Check 1, 2.
Elbows.
Homeroomies.
We're on Twitch, y'all.
Make some noise for Wish One. Let's go.
Wish One. Back just in time for Wish One. Let's go.
Wish One.
Hey, fellas. Watch.
Oh, snap.
Wait, what's going on here, man?
Oh, overlay. Nice.
Wish One. Okay. Let's go.
Yeah.
Sneaking it into school, huh? I see. Man.
Was that an overlay?
No. I took the picture when I went to go visit the school.
Ah, so you made it open. Yeah, that's dope, man. I was about to say, yeah, you know, we need to straighten up our wiring up under the table. Like, good God, I saw that right now. I was like, oh, wait, hold up.
hey, Wish, was that the time when you came into the school?
Yeah, exactly.
So you sneak a pit. Ah, I see. You sneaky bastard, you.
All right, kick it off, Rhett.
Yeah, all right. Off, yeah. Tight. So now, just overall is great. You show great hand control, great combinations. Of course the presentation is great. Thank you for promoting the school, you killed it, dude. Great job, Wish.
Wish, super dope flow, man. You know what you're doing. You know what scratches you have in your arsenal, and you know how to get, you know what scratch you're going to do next. Like I always say to like anybody, and I kind of learned this from like watching D all these years, like you kind of got to be like two or three scratches ahead of what you're already doing. And I feel like you're already there in that mode. You know what I'm saying? Like you're thinking ahead before you even jump to the next sound or what you're going to do. So that's why your flow is super tight like it is. And yeah, man, I appreciate what you're doing. And yeah, breaking into the school and rocking it when we weren't there, man. And you could have cleaned up a little bit, but it's all good. But yeah, man, salute, man. Good job, brother.
Thank you.
Yes, sir.
Wish one, man. I really liked how you rolled the beat, man. Like you complimented that beat, and you had you had all your scratches down, and then you even did you used both of the sounds of the fresh, that you used the fret and the sh. And it was just fire. That was the first thing I thought was when that beat came on and you started doing the scratch. It was just fire. And it was good control of all the beat. You're a G because you already know like all the OG DJ cuts and stuff. I remember you talking about like you enjoyed when we showed like a video or something in one of the
clouds. Oh yeah, when you guys
So you know like about Tough Crew, you know about all that shit. So it shows that you know the history of cuts, and you didn't do too much. Like it was perfect, man. That was definitely perfect. That was the one I wanted more on. Definitely. That shit was fire. Fire.
Thank you. Appreciate that.
Shortcut, what you got to say, Short?
Oh, Shortcut's up in here. What up, Short?
He's on Twitch. He just gave us a sub.
He's on Twitch.
He's on Twitch.
Five pieces.
Hook up a gift sub. I need a gift sub, y'all.
Hey, shouts out to everybody on Twitch. If you like what you see, beatjunkies.tv.
Yeah, what up, Twitch? Yes. What up, y'all?
Join us.
Let them know how we
level up your skills.
You already know. Well, yeah, y'all. Wish, awesome job, man. I loved it. Super funky. Super funky. Way to control the phrase and make the most out of the straight phrasing. Yeah, you know, I love seeing you apply a bunch of stuff we were touching on all month, and yeah, it came out really dope, man. Good stuff.
Thank you.
Yeah, man.
A lot from you guys, man. Oh, I'm sorry. Go ahead.
No, sorry. I was just gonna add, man. You definitely have your phrasing now locked. Yeah. It's cool to hear you incorporate that, you know, those two fast releases into the stab. And it's like, you know, once you learn that pattern, it becomes like real, like addicting, right? Like to just repeat it and keep going. But yeah, I would love to hear you build on that and add your own personality and style into that more. You know what I mean? But that was dope, man. Super dope.
Thank you. Thanks, man. Yeah. Learning those skills from you guys is just, it's fun to add to the repertoire, you know what I mean? And now that I kind of get the foundation, now I can kind of tweak it out, put more and more of my own spice onto it. But yeah, man, thank you guys for teaching us this stuff.
There it is.
Home Roomies, Wish One, killing it. Makes
Wish
it
go. One, word up. Dope.
Stuff Wish. All right, y'all. Next up. Where are we at? Sorry. Ah, shit. Jam. Burglar, where you at?
Jam
Burglar. What up, Jam?
Oh, Jam.
Oh, Jam Burglar.
Jam Burglar.
It's my homeroom.
What up, man?
Jam Burglar.
All right. I know we're about to see a 4 or 5 turntable get down right now, man. So let's see what happens.
Oh, my God. I always look forward to this.
Yeah, here we go. Here we go.
Make some noise. It's Jam Burglar, y'all. Let's go.
Jam Burglar. Let's go.
Jam. Never fails to stump on.
Just to let you know,
I'm using D Styles kit. All right, kick it off, D, since he showed it off.
Yeah. There you go, D. It's all you.
Uh-huh.
Jam, man. You're always always killing it with that. And I mean, you know, like I love that you're using tools that we share, you know, in class. You know, the fact that you use that kit, it's just dope to hear you flip it like in your own style, you know what I mean? And you know, I think one thing I wanted to hear more is just you just soloing and going off, but I love how you built up the song and, you know, added the bass line and the drums. Yeah, man, always impressive, always dope, man.
Jam Burglar, man, oh man, dude. You know, it's funny, man, whenever I see your videos, I can always tell you got a lot of cuss in your arsenal. And I know that you could really go off if you really want to, but I think you kind of hold back a little bit just for the sake of what you're producing. Just so it could match to what you're doing with the beat or whatever. And I could just tell, man, like your flow is really, really dope. You have a really dope flow. You have dope cuts in your arsenal. And one thing I wanted to see from you though on this one, and I know a lot of DJs do this a lot. Whenever you're scratching with the echo on, there's sometimes I do want to hear your cuts without the echo, or maybe like just turn down your depth a little bit so I can hear more of the cuts over the echo. You know what I'm saying? I'm not mad at like a little reverb sounding or anything like that when you're scratching, but sometimes I think the echo kind of kills it a little bit when you're cutting, because I comprehend what you're doing, but I want to hear more of the cuts come out a little bit more of your own style without the echo effect on it also too. But other than that, man, super dope and funky as always, man. Super creative with the foot pedal and everything that you got going on over there, man. And salute to you, brother, as always, Grubber Knot. Jam Burglar, let me get it right.
Jam. Real quick, Jam, all that stuff, did you layer that? Is that using D's kit? Is that all original composition?
Yeah, so a couple weeks ago, I guess D put that kit out. He did it in one of the classes. So after class, usually what I do is I try to make my own scratch composition out of the samples he did. And so it's just layered on the pedal. Yeah, and you know, to what Chalk was saying, what happens for me anyway, I'm still trying to figure out how to integrate the pedal with the scratching, because you get in pedal mode, you're trying to figure out how to, you know, bring the beat in and everything, and then all right. Of a sudden, bam, all right, now you got to scratch and be on time. Yeah. And I struggle with that some, for sure.
I'm sure if you practice enough, because I mean, I'm sure when D does it, he had to practice it obviously to know when to you know, just it's like being a drummer per se, I guess, you know. But no, that was dope. It was really dope. I have nothing to add except, you know, that was well, another thing I want to ask, how did you do the video to show your looper and stuff? Like, I mean, how did you to do it on time? Look at the video. Like, I mean,
I used two cameras and then just went back in and I got a little program called UCut, believe mm-hmm. it or not. You could do a picture in picture in there. Mm-hmm. I just did it on my phone.
Oh, so when you were videotaping it, it was recording at the same time. And then did you, and then when you edited the video, did you able to cut back and forth instant?
Yeah, I just put it in basically about the same time.
Oh, okay.
I
was kind of wondering how you did that, but no, that's dope. That's really dope. So great job there. Jam.
Oh, jam.
Jam.
All right, enough for that. Hey, Jam, I'm just gonna add that was fire. I love how you incorporate all this stuff into your routines, into your scratches. Like every time, it's definitely something we all look forward to in the community here, because you always knock it out the box. And yeah, that was dope, man. Real nice. Great way to use all the D Styles kit and to make that music, that did all that shit, man. It was just a good job, man. Very, very dope, man. And if anybody's watching wants that kit, you got to be a homeroomie, man. You can't just get that kit in the street.
Ooh.
Church.
Thanks, y'all. I mean, I just wanted to say the whole scratch composition thing opened up a lane for a lot of us. I feel like it, you know, it allows you to express yourself to another degree with it. And so just wanted to give the appreciation to everybody. I know you all, you know, helped pioneer that. So kind of open up the lane for a lot of us to be able to express ourselves.
What was your style before then? You were just trying to, like, this made you want to, when'd you buy your pedal? That's the question.
I got the pedal and maybe, I think I got my first one around 2000 maybe.
Okay.
And you've been try to use it like on your computer and stuff.
Yeah. You
know, Rhett and Babu had stuff way early back in the 90s. Yep. The thing on is it Deep Concentration?
Yep.
You and Peanut Butter Wolf.
With Babu, they all fall down. Yep.
It was just like, okay, this is it. So I've definitely studied it for a long time.
Man, keep on going with it, Jam. And I, you were talking about you're having like a not a problem, but you're trying to like just get over that hump, pushing that pedal. It's nothing but grooving with the beat, man. Once you get and you let all that go and stop thinking about like, all right, now and this, nah. Once you get into the flow, like just even tapping your foot on beat and moving it over on the ones gonna help. You know what I'm saying? Like actually like you're drumming or something, just moving to the beat a little bit more is definitely going to bring you to that next level. And just let go of all the thoughts, like just scratch. And if you mess up, you mess up. And you know, the one thing is with DJing, nobody knows you mess up except for you. So if you're scratching and you're messing up, it may sound good to the next person and they never know. It's really in your head. It never sounds as bad as you think it's going to sound. So once you let it go with the flow, you're definitely going to get it going and it's going to be a little bit easier. Are you ballroom dancing? Someone was asking right now. You in the hall?
This is
I'm the hip hop line dancing.
So B&H customer story. Jack and Barbara, professional wildlife photographers and B&H customer. What the?
Hey, Babu, thanks for the commercial break, man.
What is going on?
Babu with the commercial break. All right, Babu. Babs is ready.
No, I'm sorry.
Hey, good job, Jam Burglar, though. That was good.
Yeah, Jam Burglar one time, man. Yeah.
No. I was trying to clear it so we didn't have to watch a commercial. So.
Babs Barker over there.
But you guys are more than welcome to run the Zoom next time. Y'all let me.
No, that's all you. You can have that.
In other words, everybody shut up.
Hey, but Jam, Love it, man. You know, I feel like, you know, it goes without saying, like, you always, like, go above and beyond, you know, with your submissions, man, you know, but I think it's really going to be refreshing when you decide to just throw on a beat and get fucking busy with your flow, because I know you're cold flow, you know what I'm saying? So, yeah, man, good stuff as always. But, yeah, I think it's going to be a cold slap in the community's face next time you throw on a beat and just go for broke and show your arsenal to us. But awesome stuff as usual. Jam Burglar, homeroomies, make some noise.
Jam.
Hey, shout out to Peep Show in the Twitch chat.
What up, Peep?
Yeah, forget all that. Shout out to Babu for holding it down in the chat. Man, make some noise for Babu. That's what I'm talking about, man. That's
trying to get him on the good side.
We're lucky we've made it this far, guys, with me at the steering wheel. I'm still wondering how you guys let me do this. Homeroomies. Am I lying? Homeroomies been trying to get someone else to run it. They already know. We're on the edge every once a month. We're on the edge. So
Babs Harvey.
You're good, Babs. Don't worry, man.
I appreciate you guys. Homeroomies, we got a couple more left. We're almost there. Technical J, where you at?
Technical J.
Ah, shit. Shouts out to everybody on Twitch. I don't know if Technical J is with us. He'll watch us on the replay. But everybody, make some noise. Technical J, let's go. Ah, shit. Here we go.
One for the bass and two for the treble. It's on the highest level.
Make some noise.
Hey,
damn. Technical J.
Then he'd be calling people out right there.
Man, one thing I love about just scratching, period, man, I love to see DJs who can scratch without the crossfader. And Technical J, you got impeccable hand control there, brother. And I think that's what really makes a good scratch DJ also, too, is to have not only good hand control on the fader, but hand control on the record also, too. Technical J, you have both. And pretty amazing job, man. Nice, super dope flow. And you kind of just knew when to get technical and when to kind of keep it like just slow and funky also at the same time too, man. So salute to your overall flow, Technical J. Dope job, man. Salute.
Kick it, J.
Oh, shit. I was waiting. I got my notes.
Cold as ice over there, Redmatic.
Hey, it's a cold ice. It's a cold world, Mr. Chalk.
Woo.
Technical J, I'm going to say, just what Chalk was saying, you got a nice arsenal of cuts. I really like the double time cuts that you were doing with that slow beat. And I really like the, you knew the beat, and I liked how you stopped when the beat stopped, and then you came back with the beat. I really liked how you, the whole flow of and the way you made it happen. I mean, your cuts are sick. You just used that one sound and showed off. Everybody, you know, we've been hearing phrases and all this other stuff, and that's been good. But it's dope just to hear a quick ah and flip the way you flipped it. It was definitely dope, man. It was very technical, as your name would suggest. good job, Technical J. Good shit, man. Good job. Good slow, good use of slow and funky, man. Good use.
Yeah, man. Nothing to add except it's very technical and funky. Good shit, Jay, for reals.
Thanks, Rhett.
Hey, yeah, anytime, bro.
Technical Jay. Yeah, that was a perfect beat, man, to show off like your arsenal of cuts, and you have a lot of scratches in the toolbox right there. You're like what Chalk was saying, man, your tears are crazy. Like your control on it, you know what I mean? Being able to do all that and say all that with just by doing forward and backward tears is crazy and scary. I love how you were incorporating some of the traveling cuts. And what really stood out to me is your understanding of how to do like slow down triplets, like triplet, 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 and you go faster and faster. That's something that is very difficult to do, and you're able to pull that off, man. So great job. Super dope as always, man.
Yeah, y'all. Technical J, two thumbs up from Babu. Nothing more to say. Awesome job. Killed it. Fucking fire. Homeroomies, make some noise for Technical J.
Technical J.
Oh, yeah.
DJ.
I was so sick. All right, y'all. Awesome stuff, everybody. All right, down to our final submission, last but not least, last month's champ. Alex, where you at? Where you at?
Uh-oh, Alex.
Hey, what's up, everybody? What's up, everybody?
What's up, Alex?
Hey, how's it going?
Homeroomies, make some noise.
Alex?
Let's go.
Trying to lose belly fat, stop doing it.
Hold on. I'm trying. Bring it back, man. I'm trying to lose that belly fat.
Wow. That was awesome. Yo, Alex, man.
Kick it off, Chalk.
I don't even know what to say. I do know what to say. Yo, Alex, just like I was saying on Technical J, man, hand control on the crossfader and the record is everything. And what I love about you, man, what I've always loved about your style is just that you know when to blast off and when to take it easy. And your flow is just super dope, man. Like you go in and out of scratches, in and out of different combos all the time, man, but it's always funky, always in the pocket. And yeah, man, solid as always, Alex, as always, man. Salute to you, brother.
Appreciate it. Thanks, man.
Yes, sir, always.
I'm just gonna add, Alex, that was killer. The whole flow of it, but I especially liked the couple of things I really like was when you were cutting it up with no fader for a minute, and then it was really dope to see you just pick up the needle and bring it to the next sound and go right to it. You didn't skip a beat, nothing skipped, nothing happened. It just, you could have, as far as I, if I wasn't watching, I would have just thought you hit a cue point and kept going, you know, but it was nice the way you did it all with the flow. It just, you did that scratch, boom, and then bam, right into the next one. And I really liked the use of the fader on that fade out, man. That was nice. You really made it was all a good a composition. That was like track 9 on my DJ my DJ compilation that I was listening to, you know. Yeah, that was dope, man. Good way. And that win, not even winning, but just being crowned last month's champ, put a little fire in that that battery. And yeah, you definitely came it. You came at it like, oh, this guy won last month? Oh, snap. Okay. You know, you came at it like that, and it was dope, man. Yeah, good job, man.
Thanks,
Dramatic, what you got, man?
Aha. All I got, Alex, every time I see you, it just reminds me of the Friday night L'Octogone sessions. I mean, you and some of the guys just, you know, just always killing it on Friday. You just never cease to amaze me, man. It's just always killing it. So I got nothing to add except it's just killer. Always killing it, Alex.
Appreciate it, Rhett. Thanks, man.
New life.
Alex, I got to ask, man, how many hours a week would you say you practice?
At least an hour a day, two or three if I get lucky, but minimum an hour a day.
Oh man, okay. I mean, it's really showing, man. Like, I mean, you were always a beast, like when I would see you at the school, but just to hear your progression now, you know, is crazy. Like, what really stood out to me is now you understand how to repeat ideas. You know what I mean? Like, you're taking a phrase, you're repeating it, and you're turning these into like raps now. You know what I mean? So you're very lyrical with your sound now, you know what I mean? And that's like, once you understand technique, that's one thing, but to be able to add and be lyrical with it and combine that with technique, to me is very dangerous, you know. And you're at that point now, man. It's crazy. You know, with that said, like, you already know, like, I'm into like structure and just, you know, the way that you understand how to set up chorus, solo, blah blah blah. You know, you already understand that. Yeah, man, it's just crazy how much you've like progressed, man. So salute and great job, man.
Thanks, Steve. Appreciate it, man.
Yeah, Alex. I just think to a year ago and where you're at now, man, it just blows me away, man. Really, really amazing. I can't even I don't really have too much to add to what everyone said, man. It's great execution, man. Great hand control. Yeah, I really love the flow, man. I can really hear your voice these days, man. You know what I mean? Your voice is really starting to really cut through loud and clear, man. And I'm loving it, man. Stay on that path, whatever you're doing. Keep it up, man. And yeah, you gotta show me some shit when you come by the school sometime, all right?
It's all the shit I stole from you guys, man.
that's how we get down to the school, though, man. We got a spar suit, man. I miss everything. Long to come, man. That's the shit.
Thanks, guys. Really appreciate all the notes and the compliments, criticisms. Appreciate everything you guys do. Thank you.
Appreciate you, Alex. Homeroomies, make some noise. Alex.
Alex, yeah.
Hey, and everybody, let's make some noise for everybody that turned in a video again this month.
Word up.
I believe we had 18 submissions this month, guys. Hats off to everybody. So fucking dope. I can't say enough about everybody's submissions. The improvement, the progress we're seeing is so obvious. You know, I just said that to Alex, but everybody, you know, keep up whatever you're doing. It's paying off a little bit every day. And we appreciate you guys being with us every day. BeatJunkies.tv homeroom, y'all. You guys are the shit. But let's all get ready for crowning our slow tempo scratch challenge champ, y'all. Give me 1 second. I'm gonna go do my Steve Harvey thing. Guys, make some announcements, chit chat with everybody.
Yeah, if anyone is watching on Twitch, just to let you know. Rhett. Yep, I'm kicking it off, Jay. I'm kicking
it off, Rhett.
Kick it. I'm kicking it. So we are doing a 2-for-1 special. It's still been going on. If you sign up to BeatJunkies.com for a year subscription, you do get a free year subscription to BeatJunkies.tv.
Yeah,
so,
you do.
Yes, if you're watching it on Twitch, this is like we're doing. This is like our monthly community challenge that we do with our homeroom crew, or as Baz would say, the homeroomies. You know, so and it's a great community because they're every, you know, like they're pretty much almost all over the world and stuff. And we're very blessed to have them part of our, you know, part of our community. So if you are interested and just join our community and able to learn at the same time and get some dope music, sign up 2-for-1 special, beatjunkies.com, a free 1-year subscription. Get a free year subscription to beatjunkies.tv.
That's right.
Redmatic, everybody. Redmatic. Yes.
Yeah.
All right, guys. So, as usual, Zoom lets us put 10 people up in the poll. As much as we'd like to put everybody up there, we try our best to shine light on our 10 favorites. But, you know, we all win every time we turn in these videos, guys, and we hang out in these community chats. I think this is one of the biggest things that's been helping all of us, guys. For us as instructors, to see you guys, your progress and where you're at really helps us approach our lessons. You have no idea. And I think for you guys to, you know, have the balls and the nerve to put yourselves out there for criticism, you know, it's going a long ways with all of you guys' progress, guys. And we appreciate you guys being brave and being so open to share. And, you know, we hope you guys continue to train with us. You know, we all trying to get better together. And yeah, guys, the energy goes full circle. So let's crown our champ. The poll goes up. And it goes out now.
Oh, yeah.
Remember, everyone, you have one vote. One vote.
Wait, hold up, Babs. Before we do this, before anybody votes, you got Technical J on there twice.
God damn it.
Yeah.
So
let's fix that first.
Steve Harvey.
No, don't do that, Rhett.
Don't do that, Rhett.
Rhett's hosting the community challenge next month.
I'm actually out of town.
No, man, I'm just playing with you, Rhett. Don't worry. I ain't putting that on you, brother. I ain't putting that on you, Ricky Bobby. Don't worry.
Hey, Rhett, make the announcement again.
Yep. 2-for-1.
2-for-1. Hey, everyone that's watching on the Twitch, we are doing, if you're watching right now, we're doing a special live. This is what we do every month on BeatJunkies.tv, our community challenge. So it's just all our students on BeatJunkies.tv called Homeroom. So we call them homeroom crew or the homeroomies, whatever is comfortable with the guys, but and the ladies. But we do this every month after we teach our lessons, and it's kind of like to help see, you know, challenge our students to see where they're at. And it's very inspiring, what level they are. Cause as Babs says, it helps us become better instructors, even better DJs, get inspired and stuff. So we are doing a 2-for-1 special. So if you sign up for beatjunkies.com for a year subscription, you get a free year subscription to beatjunkies.tv, which is our online school. So if you see everyone in the chat that's participating and they say it's a great thing to do, yes, please, please take advantage of it. So, and be part of our community.
Hey, I'm going to say it like this, just to back Red up real quick, y'all. Everybody on Twitch, illest record pool in the game, illest DJ school online, and also physically in Glendale also too. So get your 2-for-1 special right now. Be a part of both of them. And yeah, get your DJ bars up, get your music game up, and that's what it is, y'all. 2-for-1 special right now, beatjunkies.com, beatjunkies.tv. That's what it is. Boom!
I sound like I was listening to Power 106 right now.
Yeah, baby.
Akka's saying free chalk towel while they last.
Yep, get them now.
And sing a song now, we're waiting.
Different colors, too. Mr. Chalk shirt, Mr. Chalk towel. Get them.
What color this time?
I mean, whatever you want. Black, red, green.
Blue
car, you know what I'm saying? 2 C's in your name for a reason, brother. Two C's
in
your name.
Ain't no red over here. Ain't no dead over here.
Except for D. D's, right. D's a blood. What's up, bro? D's about to shank me.
You about to start.
You were kicked the knife out of his hand, right?
You throw a star at him.
Red got nunchucks.
Nunchucks and smoke pellets.
Smoke pellets.
Ninja Matic, y'all don't know. Y'all better know. Shit.
Crime. Y'all don't know Red fights crime?
Yep. We over here starting fights now with everybody. Mm. Oh, you talking shit? Word? Hold up. Red Matic, come over here, brother.
When are you on American Ninja, Rat? When?
Sorry, guys. Here we go. My bad.
Last season, Jay. Last season.
American Ninja.
Wait, what are you guys calling Rat Show Kasugi?
Ninja Matic, man. Fighting crime at Cerritos. Crime fighter.
Rhett knew about Shokasugi. See, Rhett knew he could. Yeah. All right, y'all, sorry for the delay. Let's give this poll one more shot. My bad. Here we go now.
All right.
One choice, y'all. So take your time.
One choice it is. All right. I'm making my choice. I'm doing it. I've submitted. I'm good to go. Rhett, you should do a promo item stars, dude. Seriously, like ninja stars.
Would you buy it?
I would.
All right.
With your logo on it, though.
Okay. So I see. So when you throw it at somebody, they'll know it's me. So you can get away with it, right?
Exactly.
or the ninja the ninja shoes with like one toe.
I was gonna think of doing a mask.
Ninja mask. Yeah, why not?
Yeah.
Red Matic Ninja Mask.
Yeah.
Ninja Matic.
All right, we're waiting on like three more votes. Whoever hasn't voted yet, we got about 30 more seconds.
Book, it's okay, because I know if I choke him out, it's over.
I'm gonna sue. You choke me out. You gonna be in court.
All right.
Televised court.
Judge Mathis.
People's court. Oh my god.
Seriously.
All right. We got about 10 more seconds. We're waiting on one more vote, but we're just going to
move. Oh, man, who the heck?
Who is it? Who's the champ this month? Last month's champ was Alex, right?
Yep, he came in swinging.
Let's see, did he retain his title, or do we have a new champion?
Voting is closing in 10, 9, 8, 7, 6,
5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
4, 3, 2, 1, and here are our results, y'all.
Uh-oh. Who is it? Oh, snap. Okay. Coming in second place, we got Wish One. And coming in first place, I think this is first time winning the title.
Wait, I think you're wrong.
You're wrong, Chalk. Hold on.
Hold on. I said second place.
No, but second place. Nope. You have to scroll down.
Whoa. You're right. I didn't scroll down.
You almost pulled it.
I almost messed up. Okay, so coming in third place is Wish One. My bad, y'all. Coming in second place, we got Technical J. And coming in first place and retaining his title for the second month in a row, make some noise for Alex, everybody.
Speech for Alex.
Speech, champ. What you got to say, champ?
I want to thank you guys, honestly, first and foremost for, I mean, blessing us with the gifts that you guys have. I mean, without you guys, we wouldn't be here. I know every single one of us has grown tremendously. I know I have. I look forward to each and every class. I mean, it's an honor to be taught by you guys. You guys are the kings, the legends, and we're very fortunate to have you guys as teachers, man. And thank you. Thank you, homeroom.
Yeah.
Checks in the mail.
Congratulations, Alex, man. And thank you for the kind words, man. We really appreciate and love everybody here in our community, whether in our physical school or our online school, man. And, you know, this community that we've built over the last year and some change now is amazing, just to see you guys grow. I mean, some of you guys we haven't seen physically in a classroom or anything like that at all. But again, we see you guys every day in class, and we see you guys once a month here doing the community challenge. So to see you guys' growth within all of that is pretty amazing, man. And I just congratulations to each and every last one of you guys for being a part of our, of the community, but also evolving and growing also too, man. Very proud of each and every last one of you guys. And yeah, man, salute. That's all I gotta say. Salute.
Did we announce the new challenge?
Yeah, go ahead, Rhett.
I don't know what it is. No, it's okay. It's all you, Chalk. I think you tied it out last week, right?
Yes. So for the new community challenge for this month, everyone, we are using Impeach the President, the original song, all right? I started teaching this week. But look for us to be teaching lessons around Impeach the President, the Honey Drippers, all this month. And I'm looking forward to see what you guys bring for the next month, October. Woo! We're already in September. Isn't that crazy? Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, y'all.
Hey, Chalk, so that means trick mixing, beat juggling, anything goes?
Yes, trick mixing, cutting it up, making your own composition out of using Impeach. I mean, whatever you want to do. I mean, I think it's pretty much free game right now, right? Am I right, Babu, D-Styles?
Sounds good. That sounds good.
Yep, so juggle, trick mixing, cutting it up, just getting busy with the song Impeach the President, y'all. And again, all of us junkies are going to be teaching different lessons over the next month. And again, can't wait to see you guys' submissions and see what you guys do for this next challenge coming up. Closing words from anybody in the junkies. Let them know.
Thanks, everybody. Y'all killed it. Yeah. Keep up the great work, y'all. Appreciate you guys putting in that work. We'll see you guys 3 p.m. every day.
Yep.
You guys are the shit. Appreciate everybody. Homeroomies, much love.
Yep.
See you guys tomorrow at 3 p.m.
Stay safe, you guys. Stay sharp, stay sane. You already know what it is. See Brett Maddock on Monday. You'll see me on Tuesday. J-Rock on Wednesday. Babu on Thursday. And either Shortcut or Dynamics on Friday. Saturday, Mellow D. Sunday, D-Styles. You know what it is, y'all.
Be you know what TV. It is.
All right. You see it. You see it. Peace, y'all. Be safe. Bye.